And we're back! Hey everybody, welcome back! Lala's here playing some more Warcraft 3 campaign. Starting with the Frozen Throne, after I finish the Frozen... starting with Reign of Chaos, after I finish Reign of Chaos, I will go straight into the Frozen Throne campaign. So yeah, here we are, next level. We destroyed the first of the elf gates in the last level.
Trees! You've won through this gate, Butcher, but you won't get through the second. The inner gate to Silvermoon can only be opened with a special key, and it shall never be yours.
You waste your time, woman. You cannot outrun the inevitable.
You think that I'm running from you? Apparently, you've never fought elves before.
Sylvanas is great.
Damn that woman! We must find a way to cross the river.
So we get Nerubians on this level. However, Nerubians are not the thing that I need. I really think this level should have been the level that you get,
What is it?
I really think this level should have been the level that you got,
Our forces
gargoyles
and attack the flying beasts.
Fear not. The crypt fiends can force them to the ground.
Don't want to lose any necromancers.
The dead shall serve.
Crypt fiends are actually insanely good because of the ensnare ability.
Speak, fool.
No one orders clean the ground.
I wish only to serve.
So this is one of the levels that I actually really, really hate. On hard mode, I recall it being like actually super hard.
The restless dead await as the shadow wills.
Frostborn hungers.
What does the shadow will?
Where shall my blood be spilled?
My life for Nezul.
Man, I'm really, really excited for Tuesday, so I can record Valhalla 3.
Spill your will, thy bidding, master.
That game is sick. That game's like super cool.
The dead shall
no one orders me around.
This probably has like one of the best end games for that like genre of game ever.
What is it now?
Alrighty,
where
so for this level.
Spilled?
The only new thing that I get is, I believe, a couple upgrades and the Nerubians. Well, Crypt Fiends. But the problem is that, like, the meat wagon strat's kind of shitty on this level. Because of how I have to move my units around. So, I'm going to want a few Necromancers, but I'm not going to use six, because it's going to be hard to maintain that number of corpses. So I'll probably have, like, three or four. A handful of ghouls and a handful of crypt fiends, and I'll try to make that work. The crypt fiends are really, really important since they do have a lot of AoE. So, a lot of aerial. So the problem is that with those levels, I need to destroy these three altars.
Summoning is.
But
complete.
They're through a really annoying warp gate system.
Thy bidding.
Which is just frustrating.
My life.
Oh shit! I have some blinds, so I can ziggurat it up.
I gladly obey.
Summoning is complete.
Yes, master.
Cool.
I gladly obey. Yes, master.
Summon more ziggurats.
Oh my god. Working on it.
No one orders me around. This is more like it.
We can't even have
Frostborn
a sacrificial.
This is more like it.
Hit yet?
At last.
I live in the face of danger.
Frostborn hungers. Tread lightly.
summoning is complete.
Yeah.
Summoning.
So there's
is
the
complete.
Waypoint, and that's really fucking
summoning
annoying.
Summoning is complete. What is it now?
All right. Well, I got the zeppelins. These are the transports. These I need to use to move around. Again, I wish I got gargoyles on this level instead of crypt fiends, and crypt fiends on the next level. Because with gargoyles, this level, like, I would feel a lot better about army composition.
Where shall my blood be spilled? The damned stand ready. I will be done thy bidding, master.
More gold is required.
Yes, master.
I was gonna say, it's pretty close.
Are you threatening me?
Oh shit.
The restless dead await.
I also can't wait to record some battle for Westnoth. That game is so good.
What is it now? This is more like it.
Oh, you know what? I should have bought a Scroll of Town portal or two on the last level, because on this level they can be really, really helpful. But oh well.
I bow to your will. I cannot summon there. My fate is sealed. Summoning is complete. Thy will be done.
Wow, still no upgrades, okay.
I wish only to serve.
Can this I just make do with the two necromancers?
Where shall my blood be spilled?
Because I'm not going to make meat wagons, so there's kind of no reason for me to go up at attack level.
Tread lightly. Summoning is complete.
Wow, on normal it really takes a while for you to actually get attacked. Complete. All right. Okay, so basically on this level, I need to fight through this stuff to get to this waypoint, and that waypoint will take me to somewhere over here, which will allow me to go destroy this one, and then there'll be a waypoint that will take me to somewhere around here, which will let me destroy this one. And then I have to make it to the gate, which is like all the way up here or some crap. It's pretty annoying.
Speak, fool. No one orders you. Research
complete. Holy shit. I mean, the meat wagons are really not that helpful on this level anyways.
This is more than Frostmourne hungers.
More gold
upgrade
is required.
Complete.
You rang.
This is one thing that I hate about Undead in a lot of games, is that in a lot of games, the full like Undead team gets a little weird. So in this game, right, you have ghouls, and you have acolytes, and necromancers, and death knights, and you're like, this all checks out. You have abominations, which I'm fine with. The meat wagons are pretty cool. And you have like crypt fiends, where it's like, well, they're undead spiders. Why would undead like just be human? And I'm like, well, okay, fair, but undead spiders? And then you have like gargoyles. I'm like, what the fuck do gargoyles have to do with the undead? Like, they always start to move like really, really far away. And I'm like, the undead dragons are sick. And I'm like, this makes sense. Yeah.
more gold is required.
They're powerful, they make sense, and it's something where it's like, yeah, this is a non-human thing that you would want to raise. Undead fucking dragons. Yes. 10 out of 10, that's amazing.
You rang.
I always prefer it when the undead are just like, it's just undead. Because like, there is enough there to make a whole thing in games based on it. But I feel like a lot of games are like, well, what would make sense for a rage thing? And they just kind of like don't like. I don't know. Like I don't know what my complaint actually is really, besides that it just always feels a little wrong to me. That the undead feel a little less undead than they usually do. Okay. That is a reason to go to Halls of the Dead, which means I will get a Temple of the Damned, make like two more Necromancers and get the upgrades. I was pretty sure that I would, because I was pretty sure I'm allowed to go to 2-2 on this level, but, you know. I wanted to make sure before I just dumped all my resources into this unnecessarily.
No one orders me around.
My life for Nezu.
Ah, at last. This is more like it. Finally. This is more like it. Frostmourne hungers. Finally.
Research complete.
Proceed.
How much range do I think?
You rang.
Okay.
Make your choice.
Yep.
What is it now?
Are you threatening me? You scared me! They all look like ants from here! Shiny buttons! Where's the equator? You worry about the towers. I'll worry about the mini-man.
What's done is done. Yes, master.
I wish only to serve.
Kind of sour that I'm already on low upkeep, but I can maintain low upkeep just fine.
I bow to your will.
Upgrade complete.
Yes, master. Thy will be done.
Next level, I might just go mass gargoyles to keep the playstyles more varied rather than just going necromancers every game. Because I recall the next level, gargoyles being really, really good on.
The sleeper awakes. Make your choice. Proceed.
No one orders me around.
Make your choice.
Required.
The calm before the storm.
Summoning is complete.
The reason why I'm spending so much time preparing for this level is that once I cross over here, I'm gonna just want to take everything I have and try to beat the whole thing. Which isn't necessarily gonna be easy, so. One thing that's kind of annoying too is like, okay, so they give you these zeppelins to let you cross from here to here, and you can buy more zeppelins. And theoretically, you could use the zeppelins to fly over to like these places, but these are like little islands that have a lot of really powerful anti-air towers. And I think the idea is after like going through here, if you like destroy this, you can destroy all the towers and then just fly your zeppelin to there, or something like that. But the reality is it's just a giant pain in the ass.
Search complete.
Who's that?
Speak, fool.
Must be it. Hey.
It's three.
Who's that?
So I have six right now.
More gold is required.
Fair.
No one orders me around.
I can't wait till I get to the Frozen Throne campaign. The expansion of this game, the campaign levels, are so much better. Not that these are bad, it's that the game gets that much better. Like, they made some very clever, very fun, very creative, very streamlined levels. I don't think there's a single level I find annoying in the campaign. There's ones that kind of take a while. Like, the first campaign in the expansion will probably be the longest for me.
The shadow.
Just because of how worth it is to do your due diligence and all the side stuff. But yeah. I could just take the ones that are harvesting lumber right now.
The restless okay. Wait.
So this is going to be control group Tread 2, lightly. And this will be control group 1. Yeah, I'll just take these three.
No one orders me around. Frostmourne hungers.
Still missing one. Okay, never mind.
What is it?
So it's
now?
One and two. Serve. I know there's the one more ghoul over there, but that one ghoul probably isn't gonna make a significant difference.
Speed ahead!
What does the shadow will?
Speak, fool.
Research complete.
At last.
Research the restless complete. Dead await.
What?
What does the shadow will? As the shadow wills.
Ah!
I love the sounds of like every goblin unit. That's not an Easter egg, but a silly thing that Blizzard games do. If you click on the same unit multiple times, they'll go through lots of different dialogue. Wait. And after, I believe it's like 6 or 8, they'll go to just funny dialogue.
Full speed ahead! What?
Okay.
No one orders me around.
The dead shall serve. Our forces are under
did
attack.
Did I? Okay, cool. Fine, I'll get the research now.
The restless dead await.
What is it?
The dead shall serve.
Our town is under attack.
Research complete.
It's totally fine. Tower's OP. Okay, turn off raise dead.
Fine, this is better.
Another one? That's interesting. Oh, it's probably if your zeppelins die, you'll still be able to make it back over, if that makes sense.
Speak, fool. The restless dead await.
Our forces are under attack.
As the shadow moves.
This is what you did. Frostborn hungers.
So there's an expansion
no
here. As though the later levels, I probably will expand. For now, I don't really want to because, well, I should have enough to beat the level anyways. But in the later levels, that's a way to deal with upkeep. You just get a second gold mine, and then you're getting more gold than you were on low upkeep than without upkeep. Anyways, so you can maintain a decent amount of income.
The rest was dead. Await.
I actually need to destroy these altars.
This trend lightly.
At last.
I guess agility doesn't help me at all, right? Because your primary stat's strength.
Of the three moons. The other two crystals must be found if the elf gate is to be unlocked.
What is it now?
The dead
that's one thing that would be baller about this game, is if Blizzard did come back and make it so that it had updated menu options, would be like baller. But also fixing the cinematic issues that the game has. So these towers are really, really OP. These are the Sky Fury ones. I believe this is, yeah, like surrounded by them. So basically you can't just fly in.
Tread lightly.
This better be good.
No one orders me around.
The restless dead always is under attack.
Tread lightly.
What does the shadow do?
Gold mines all over the place. I actually recall on hard mode, there was one time where I ran out of a lot of my army, so I just flew the Zeppelin over here, made an expansion here, and then just like rebuilt my army here because it was easier. Normal difficulty is a lot easier than hard.
Speak the dead should serve.
No one orders
them. What does the shadow will? Speak this battle.
Frostborn hungers.
Our forces are under attack.
Finally. Tread lightly.
The dead shall serve.
That should be enough to destroy the building. Maybe not. Doesn't matter because I don't have to destroy the building anyways, but find it hard to find something to say because I don't know much about Warcraft to start with. It's all good, man. And if you just want to ask questions about like the story and stuff, like by all means.
No one orders.
What does the shadow will?
I grew up playing Warcraft 1. But Lawless, you're not that old. No, but our technology was that outdated in my household. I've actually explained this before, where basically, one of my neighbors, had, two sisters, two younger sisters, and I lived next door, So I was basically his, like, pseudo younger brother. And he had just got Warcraft 2 and was loving the game. And I would go over and watch him play and said that it looks super cool. And he goes, well, I still have Warcraft 1 and your computer should be able to run it. Do you want to play Warcraft 1? And I'm like, yeah, I would love to check it out. So he gave me Warcraft 1. Just, like, gave it to me. And I played it and immediately fell in love with RTSs. I had played one of the Command and Conquers before, but, like, wasn't a huge fan. Nowadays, I love the Command and Conquer series. I don't know why I didn't like it as a kid, but I think I just didn't really like military stuff as a kid. I preferred high fantasy, Lord of the Ringsy stuff and whatnot. But anyway, so I played through Warcraft 1, and then years later, Warcraft 2 Battle.net Edition was on sale, well, on clearance in Target.
Our forces are under attack.
Speak, the rest is dead.
And so I picked up that and played Warcraft 2. Then that same neighbor, my pseudo older brother, had got a copy of Warcraft 3, the battle chest. However, his computer was not good enough to run the game, but mine was, because we had recently gotten a new computer at that point. So he brought it over, we installed it on my computer, and played through the Warcraft 3 campaign for the first time together. What an experience. And it was, like, relatively new. It was, like, a year after the game had come out or something. So, gaming at that time was, like, this was, like, the best of the best. Fucking incredible. Wonderful experience. After that, I never got into World of Warcraft because I thought the idea of an MMO was pretty dumb. And I was too young where there's no way in hell I could possibly afford to play an MMO because of the subscription costs. So I just never played World of Warcraft for quite a while. But I started reading the Warcraft books, and I don't think there's a single book that has been a bad book. There are some that I didn't enjoy, but there were ones that I loved. But they were all really well written. Like, the Warcraft books are incredible. A lot of people talk about the Star Wars books and the extended universe of that and how it's really, really good. Warcraft's the same way. The Warcraft books are fucking incredible. Yes, very much so, story time. And so I know a shit ton about the lore, especially Warcraft 1 / Warcraft 2 era. I really love the lore around there. I did eventually play World of Warcraft around when they were making
what is it now? The dead shall serve.
Wrath of the Lich King. Around that time I started I picked up the World of Warcraft battle chest from GameStop, and that was with the Burning Crusade. So I played through the Burning Crusade till pretty much endgame. And a lot of people say that that was like the money time to play, that the Burning Crusade was like one of the best expansions ever. And then I stopped playing because we didn't want to play, or we didn't want to pay the subscription anymore. And I was like, yeah, I feel like I got what I wanted out of this. But I have been following the development cycle of the of World of Warcraft and whatnot, and some of my friends still play and talk to me about it and all that stuff. I actually know quite a bit about Warcraft. As per usual, my casual tryhardness, when I do enjoy a game, I play it so fucking much and get just fully developed and enthralled in it. And don't play anything else for a while, and that was Warcraft for me for quite a few years. Let's get the fuck out of here. My forces are getting a little small. I still have this one to do, but this one should be easier than this one. That's why I chose to do this side first, was because I knew this side would be harder to deal with.
What is it now?
And I didn't want to lose, like, two or three units here, and then come to the harder area, lose two or three more units, and then be like, I can't deal with this now.
Speak, inventory is full. At last.
What?
Finally.
It should combine.
This
yeah.
is more like it.
The second moon crystal is ours.
Useless dead await.
Tread lightly.
This better be good.
Yeah, skeletons, fuck them up!
What is it now?
What does the shadow will?
Speak,
the
fool.
Dead shall serve.
Yeah, my older brother is the same person who introduced me to Diablo 2, and we played Diablo 2 together a lot. I tried to get him in on our last hardcore game of
now?
Diablo 2 that we
the
played on stream,
dead,
but he has like a very real job, and it's really really busy, so it didn't work out, which is fine. But oh my god, I'm at no upkeep, next level.
The rest was dead, away.
What is it? At last.
Ah. I hate projectile heals. They're like the worst mechanic in anything ever.
Fine.
I should be fine though. I thought the Dragonhawk Riders were expansion only units.
Tread,
the dead shall serve.
Cause in the expansion, every race got two units.
This is more than...
And I'm pretty sure that the humans got Dragonhawk Riders and Spellbreakers. Spellbreakers, by the way, are super OP. I'm gonna use the shit out of them in the expansion in human campaign. I guess we should call it the Alliance campaign, because you're not actually playing as humans, technically, but yeah. I remember my older brother played Warcraft when we were younger, but it wasn't enough fun. Which one? Do you know if it was 1, 2, or 3? As I thought, the potion of healing would in fact be useful on this level. Okay, come over here, Arthas.
At last,
the restless dead.
No one will just leave me alone.
We're down to one control group.
What is it now? Frostborn hunger. This is more like it.
Oh shit, I think I'll also have to make it up to there. I might need to restock my army.
Tread lightly. What is it now?
Our forces are under attack.
I'm gonna not destroy this whole base because I don't think I need to. I'm just gonna kind of skirt the edge all the way up here.
Last. No one orders me to ground.
He can tank the tower and kill it.
Frostborn hungers. No one orders me to ground.
Last, the third moon crystal. The key of the three moons is complete.
Speak, fool.
Oh, that's it. Okay, cool. I thought I had to make it to the gate. The gate is actually up here, and you can get to it. And I think if you do go there, it's just like, sorry, but like, you need the key. Oh, there we go. Okay, yeah.
This is more like it. Frostmourne hungers. Ah, at last.
Are
you threatening me?
Tread lightly.
The dead shall serve.
My internet literally got shut down.
For
the
Lich King.
Totally cool. Wills. I mean, I'll be playing for quite a few hours more. So if you can tune back in later, let me know.
Ah!
What is it now?
Frostmourne hungers.
Intriguing.
What? Full speed ahead!
Tread lightly. At last.
And quest complete.
Finally.
The gates have been opened. Once we've dealt with Sylvanas, the Inner Kingdom shall be ours.
Okay, so I think this is the worst level. The level I least enjoy.
What will it take to drive you back?
The Manger Woman is starting to vex me greatly.
The Fall of Silverrune. Moments later, in the outskirts of the Elves' capital, Silverrune. Alright, thanks everybody for tuning in. I'm gonna do a cut here. I almost forgot to do that. So if you're watching on YouTube, thanks so much. You'll see the next video tomorrow. Unless you're watching it way in the future, in which case the whole playthrough will be there. Thanks so much for the support. Thanks so much for tuning in. Enjoy the end slate. If you're watching on stream, you will see the next level. Like pretty much now. I'm just going to take a quick break for editing reasons, and I'll be back and start the next level. Hey everybody, thanks so much for tuning in. If you don't mind giving this video a like, that shows your support. It makes a huge difference. Also, feel free to subscribe to the channel if you would like to see more of my regular content. And if you want to tune in live to see what I do, well, for a wide variety of other games and whatnot, tune into my Twitch channel, which there should be links in all of this in annotations and in the description below. Also, follow my Twitter to get live notices to know when I am going live on Twitch. Every bit of support makes a huge difference and is much appreciated, so thanks so much for watching, and with that, I will see you next time.